Hi viewers, I am Pawan Krishna. You are watching Outlook Entertainment, Film and Tech. Firstly, today's topic is about BlackBerry Passport review. This is not a review, fully the full review. It's impressions and first sight. Firstly, many articles have been written about BlackBerry fall from grace and how it is completely failed to read and respond to change the market, and the sequence of poor judgment calls that transformed its product line from a different dominant cultural force into vaguely unpleasant memory. This is a company that managed to alternate its core user base, eliminate the feature they loved most, and now understand for years what it had been doing wrong. The post-decline BlackBerry product line has had more misses than hits, and the appeal of the platform has but all evaporated. And still, the company is not dead still. There are people who cling to their old phones or cry that the ones they we had to move to just do not feel right. Just like classic QWERTY, BlackBerry and will race to buy it soon as it happens. Firstly, the Passport. The Passport is not a phone, it's somethingly entirely new. It might make some of these loyal customers very happy while disappointing others, but also might appeal to those who never thought that consider BlackBerry again. It's brave. Imaginatively, device that rethinks with a smartphone should be a how it should work. Coming from a company that has spent many years in mad blind dash to keep with competitions, the product represented a massive challenge for direction. This is BlackBerry's attractive mode. Find things competitors will not do. Its strength is hardware and software, and exploiting the shortcomings of the homogeneous rectangles that all smartphones have come to be. This is company deliberately upsetting the status quo and giving buyers something different and potentially better to consider. There's a lot of that the Passport needs to do in order to break through, and we are going to give it a fair chance to do so. Look and feel. Customers clearly want large screens, and up until now that has meant disposing of everything but the screen, keyboards, control buttons, and most importantly comfort rectangular screen have become the standard. And although they are good for movies and many forms of games, they aren't the most natural shape for many other things. Sensing an opportunity to improve productivity, BlackBerry has gone with a perfectly square 1:1 screen, with room beneath it for a 3-line keyboard. This makes the phone wide and squat, only slightly wider and tall than actual Passport. It will fit in a jacket pocket, but it will look and feel awkward in a trouser pocket. It acquired to hold and carry, but not more than the today popular tablets. You might love it or hate it, and either way, it will take a while to become accustomed to. Beyond the initial impressions, my feeling, the Passport feels fantastic. Its construction and material are top notch. The phone is built around an exposed metal frame and quite hefty. But just looking and it very premium device. The front face is shiny glass, and the keyboard has BlackBerry trademark silver frets between each row. The rear, if a soft touch plastic, and is curved right just right to make this phone thickness. Nextly, the BlackBerry 10 OS is controlled entirely by on-screen gestures, so there's no need for navigation buttons. There are still volume buttons on a side with smaller button to be triggered to voice commands feature between them. The power button is on top and is really awkward to reach. There is standard 3.5mm headphone jack on top and slim port complaint. Micro USB port on the bottom. It supports HDMI ports also. The nano SIM and micro SD and card slots are concealed beneath the upper panel on the rear, which is removable. Given its high-end aspirations, the Passport comes in outside box, which include a stiff formal card with a VIP support email address printed on it that pursuits might have been hoping and wishing for. First of all, it has only 3 rows, which means the space bar divides the ZXCV and BNM keys. You all notice the lack of shift and alt modifiers. It was not horrifying enough. The key has been stripped on their alternate symbols. The secret, which is the Passport's most brilliant innovation, is that physical keyboard is only half the story. The other half of it is included in software. The keyboard is not restricted to 3 physical rows. A 4th row is visible on screen, and it can expand to show three additional rows and change according to the typing and at any time. There's also a row showing auto complete suggestions. The passport is designed with the screen and keyboard nearly touching. Make this integration extremely sleek. It's a brilliant idea. There's another huge aspect to this. The entire surface of the keyboard is touch sensitive. It can swipe your finger across, it would not a trackpad, and that is registered contextually as input. While typing, a swipe to left erases entire words at a time. You can hold down the on-screen shift key and slide a finger around the keyboard to select text as it with the cursor. You can flick upwards to fling a word from the autocomplete bar to text field. So your fingers never leave the keyboard in other places. You can scroll around by swiping across the keyboard. The idea is sheer genius and we love it. In terms of implementation usage, we had few issues. The first, we are just getting used to the keyboard layout. This is where pursuits we will feel let down. Apart from split bottom row, that their fact that shift button, punctuation and symbols are on all the soft row above the keyboard. It's a little counterintuitive and we really miss with the fourth physical row. Next one, the screen. At 1440 into 1440 pixels, the BlackBerry Passport screen is wonderfully crisp. If the device construction quality didn't clue you into a phone's premium aspirations, the screen will PC power users will wow for the fact 69 monitors, which are inescapable today and absolutely awful for productivity. The limited appeal of watching movies without black bands does not make with the loss of unusable area. When working the next graphics on spreadsheet, similarly smartphone users have become used to rotate their phones between portrait to landscape to see different aspects. The Passport One screen is completely rejection of the current status quo and it's something you could get used to very easily. It's genuinely useful to nearly every situation. BlackBerry has used spreadsheets, reports and medical emergency, imaginary and particular examples, but it works just as well for more mundane things, a calendar, hubs, map and explicit text. The company has for the most part done a good job of adapting invoice interface and default apps. Of course, third party apps are another matter. Some do scale well, others are awkward, and then there are run lettered box with black strips on either side. We are particularly unsure on that Android apps would run, but you can swipe down from the top of the bottom screen to reveal the option that lets you zoom or out of an app in case apps will crash when you do this. Temple Run 2, for example, show its splash screen in letterbox while the game's left run full screen, and it's not bad at all. It's really only video those pose a problem, but the Passport is positioned as a hardcore productivity device for high-end customers who will find enough value in the square screen, not the domain. Next one, specifications and software. BlackBerry has gone high-end with the Passport and its specs match those of current flagship phones. You will find Qualcomm Snapdragon 801 under the hood, which 4 cores running at 2.2 GHz. There's a 3 GB of RAM and 32 GB of storage space. The battery is non-removable, but a woofing of 3450 mAh capacity. You also get dual band Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.0, NFC, GPS and FM radio. Honestly, BlackBerry phones have not been able to compete on specifications in a quite while. This is the only company that has not refreshed to in flagship level offerings. The Z10 in nearly 2 ways, the Passport blows it soft off the water. Next one. On the software front, the Passport comes with BlackBerry 10.3 latest version of BB platform. The big news here in built-in Amazon App Store. This is a big step forward for users who don't have to think about how to get the apps they want. Compatibility is said to improve, and we did not have much trouble in our limited time with the Passport. OS 10.3 introduces other features and improves too. The hub is one of the most notable examples. All mails, messages and notifications go here. And now you can tap on the icon to turn on instant actions, which let perform common actions on each type of message with one tap right from the inbox view. The first home screen still shows thumbnails of running apps, but more fit on screen. The general look and feel of the OS has tricky to get the basic home guests are right. Something such as hub to take a while of new users to get you to become familiar with practice. Performance. As expected, the BlackBerry Passport feels fantastically quick and responsive in use. We had no problems at all, lags and delays. Other than physical awkwardness, we had a great time using this phone. The screen is bright and sharp. The viewing angles are not all the great. Video played well enough, but the experience was not great on the square screen. The keyboard is pleasure to use in terms of tactile quality, even if it is a little too clever. The speaker is surprisingly loud and clear. It's a dual stereo speaker. Even call quality is superb. Our Android benchmark test, it does it run. And even if the results would not easily comparable to the non-standard screen on Android compatible layer, SunSpider and Mozilla Cochrane, which runs in the browser, gave us scores of 1018.2 and 18029.2 respectively. Next one, passcode will mitigate with behavior, but it is still a concern. Battery life is very impressive. We are able to get 13 hours 43 minutes of continuous video playback time, and we noticed that the phone lasted up to 2 days with a moderate to heavy usage. The camera is very good, but some little laggings about the focusing and other data. We were more than happy than its performance, even in low details, with sharp in most cases. With only little bit blurring noticeable in distant objects, colors we are little subdued, but overall quality made up that for focusing is not quick, and the camera can detect different conditions and prompt you to enable HDR. For example, the main annoyance was that it was set to 1.9:1 cap photos by default, while square photos fill up the screen and look good on the passport. They are most likely not to want for any other purpose. Predict. My opinion, the BlackBerry innovative streak here. The phone has one of the most distinct and unique personalities of we tested so far this year. In this product of lot of smart thinking, and we have to go give BlackBerry credit for investing in the idea of crafting such a high-end product even when its company itself is down. Whether the phone would be enough to turn the company around, but it was not. But the passport might very well be, especially if there is more stuffing like coming. We think BlackBerry is really onto something here. It's targeting work professionals with specific needs beyond just being constant in touch, such as doctors, architects, and lawyers. People in these fields are most like familiar with BlackBerry device already, and could easily be willing to carry to second, if not third phone around. It is also no coincidence that they tend to be high net worth individuals. Large acquired phablets are already popular, so they are little worry about the shape and size being a turn off. There's only the question of whether people will be willing to give a BlackBerry a try. Devices such as Z10 and Z3 simply do not have the takes to stand out in a crowd of Android phones, but the passport is new and different and have very easily understandable benefits to offer. After many long years, BlackBerry might finally have done something completely right. Thanks for watching. This is the my opinion of the reviews of BlackBerry in terms of BlackBerry Passport. I give overall ratings of the design. Build quality is superb. I will give 9 points out of 10, and display is crispy and sharpness. You 8 and keyboard as well as large screen, premium construction quality, good camera, excellent battery life. Performance is also good, battery life is very good, camera is fine, not better. Value for money is such a price, it is a lot, but in 2018 price is considerable range comparatively other mobiles. Bads, inconsistent third party app support. It does not support the apps targeting above 4.4 KitKat version in BlackBerry, they are not support.